I'm Amanda, I'm a certified sex therapist, and today we're gonna talk about body image and loving yourself. Hit subscribe and like for more content and stay until the end to find out about our mirror exercise, which is something that I have my clients do to work on their sense of body image. So if you're struggling, stay until then. As a licensed marriage and family therapist, I've worked with body image and did intense work with those who had eating disorders and body dysmorphia. So I know a lot about body image concerns, and today I'm gonna teach you a little bit, just an overview about what people struggle with and maybe why they're struggling with this. Body image in Western culture is perceived as incredibly important. It's one of the things that we value the most. Body image, another way of saying that, is your inner impression of your outer appearance or others' impressions of your outer appearance. Here's the thing though about Western culture. When we focus and hyper-focus on what our body looks like and our weight, then we're not really focusing on things we want to be focusing on, like things we value: family, pleasure, growth, contribution. Your weight and your body size is honestly the least interesting thing about you. If you really believe that you're happier with less or more weight on your body, question that belief. Is it true? Is it because your bones feel better if you have less weight on you? Or is it because of what you've been taught to believe about bodies? Those are very different things. One is about health and how it feels to be you. And one is about other things that you've been conditioned to believe are true, that, you know, other values that you ought to put on yourself and your body. So is it actually true that you are more excited or happier at a different body size? If you can comment below, do weight and body size matter to you? Be mindful of how you talk in front of young ones, because they do hear what you're saying. They're like sponges. They grab and gravitate towards anything you say. Analyze what you've learned from TV, music, and movies about bodies and how you ought to feel about your body. Sometimes we start to believe that celebrities who are probably eating personalized chef meals, working with personal trainers, working with a professional hair and makeup team, audio, video, photographers. We start to believe that this might be reality when movies and TV aren't reality. The way that certain people appear and look can be edited in processing, but also they might be going to extreme measures to get those results. We're talking tens of thousands of dollars in surgery, Botox, different things like liposuction, breast augmentation. And to be clear, nothing is wrong with any of those things. It's just, why are we doing this? Are we doing it to reach some unimaginable ideal that's been created about what our body should look like? The main purpose here is not to say, forget it, don't watch any TV or movies. It's to say, be mindful that that's not real. Porn and movies are not real representations of sex or love or pleasure. What they are is entertainment and fantasy, and to get you hooked in to come back for more. So if you're really believing the things that you're seeing on TV and media, I just want you to question that. I want you to have a healthy questioning of it, because it could be taking you away from self-love. I honestly believe that if you start to compare yourself there, you're not gonna have self-love in the way that you would if those things weren't part of what you were consuming on a daily or weekly basis. Four, loving yourself, and what I'm talking about here, is actually radical. It is radical to tell your friends and family that you love yourself, that you're proud of you. Not all families do that. There's a lot of competition and jealousy at times, and envy. What ends up happening is that people trauma bond and they start to talk about how bad things are and they stack negatives. It's radical to start highlighting the gratitude, the parts that you're celebrating. Try to do this with your friends, your family. See what happens. Being happy and not letting your body size or weight interfere with your love and friendships and your pleasure is huge. It's hugely radical and it's very important because self-love and you loving yourself is going to bring you closer to the things that you value. So my top three techniques for dealing with body image. One, identify what the actual issue is. Sometimes the fixation on the body might be something else. It might be a need for control in another place or because someone has insulted you in the past. Try to find out if there is something underneath the rigid desire you have for weight and size. It might not be. So if it's not, next step. Find something new to focus your time and energy on. If you really become fixated with the numbers on the scale or with your size of the clothes and how they fit you, find something else to do. Find something else to do with your hands or your mind so that you have something else to add to your repertoire other than fixating on what you've always fixated on when it comes to your body. And finally, one of my favorite things to do, I've had clients do it, put pictures up of people that you know or people that you admire who have body shapes that are not ideal, what you would consider not ideal. Put up pictures of those people. Surround your mind with images of people who have done what you want in terms of goals, intelligence, pleasure, vision. The people that you really admire, not everyone has a body image that is magazine cover worthy. In Western culture, again, body image, what others perceive and what you perceive about your body is so important. But if you start to fill your space with other images, then it could be different. You could have access to a different type of mind and template, and that can help you love the skin you're in even more. Thank you for staying until the end. Scroll below, hit the pleasure practice guide, and do the mirror activity. Do it 40 days in a row if you have to, over and over and over until it sinks in because you deserve to love yourself and your body. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, hit like, subscribe, and the bell. I release new videos Wednesdays, 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. You can see us and ask questions on YouTube, of course, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, at The Sex Healer. Our practice is life coaching and therapy, and I'm Amanda Pasciucco. Have a wonderful day. Thanks for watching.